There is not a team in the NBA that I do not have more confidence in other than the Milwaukee Bucks, especially right now considering the landscape of the NBA, how so many teams have so many issues, but the Bucks, they seem to escape all of those problems right now in the league. As currently when you look across the NBA's contenders for a championship, there are so many issues with so many teams that we're going to talk about in this video. But that's why it leads me to believe that the Milwaukee Bucks are in a perfect position to repeat. But before we go any further with this video, I would like to give a shout out to the sponsors, and that is the channel The Game Day. Now The Game Day is a YouTube channel. They have their own website as well where they cover betting odds. But on their YouTube channel, they have a lot of nice videos. They have some series that they talk about the NFL and the NBA. And then there's one series that I personally enjoy. It's called Odd Man Sports. But the video that I'm choosing to target specifically for this promo has to be their video titled, Don't Be Too Spooked by These Spooky Team's Mascots. And I want to choose this video not only because we're in the spirit of Halloween, but it didn't really get enough credit for its editing. It keeps you engaged from beginning till end. Really props to them for making an entertaining video. But without further ado, let's get back to the subject of discussion and talk about the Milwaukee Bucks. Now, when you look at this Bucks team up and down, they have all the ingredients to win a championship again. For starters, let's address the one thing that many people said they didn't have in the playoffs last year because of the percentages, and that's shooting. Now, I understand the Bucks didn't shoot that well in the playoffs, but you have to understand that just because you have a low percentage doesn't mean that you don't have shooting on your roster. The Bucks have players that are capable of making shots, they just weren't making them during that playoff run. Last year, Jrue Holiday shot 40% from behind the arc, but in the playoffs, obviously it drastically went down as he was wildly inconsistent. Hell, you could look at Bryn Forbes, solid three-point shooter as well, as he went crazy in the Heat series. I think he even outplayed Jimmy Butler as far as the scoring totals go, but unfortunately throughout the remainder of the playoffs he received a lot of DMPs because the guy couldn't knock down a single shot to save his life. Then you combine that with fake shooter Brook Lopez, which I'll give a lot of people, yeah, he's a fraud shooter for sure, but Chris Middleton as well, he's a good shooter that you have to guard, but because he's not an elite shot creator, but he's put in a role where he has to create more than often, especially down the stretch of late close games, he's gonna have his really cold games, and we saw it a lot in the playoffs last year. But my point is, even though a lot of those guys did miss shots last year in the postseason, which led to them being the worst shooting team to win a championship, it was just more so a result of them not being able to consistently make their shots more than the fact that they can't make them. Because you're not leaving Jrue Holiday, Chris Middleton, Bryn Forbes, you're not leaving those guys open. Those are legitimate shooters. But when you look at the Bucks team this season, I would say they have even better shooters compared to last year. They brought in Grayson Allen, who's a career 38% shooter from behind the arc. They brought back George Hill, who has played with the Bucks before in the past, so he should fit like a glove. He's a really good spot-up shooter in his own right as well. And even though this guy's not going to get that many minutes, I like the pickup of Rodney Hood because he can space the floor as well. And when you throw in the other shooters they already have on the roster, and Jrue Holiday, Chris Middleton, and Brook Lopez, who can space the floor at the five, I would say that shooting is already covered on this roster. Then you move on to their defense, and I have to say, we already know what they bring on that end of the court. I've heard a lot of people mention that the loss of PJ Tucker is going to hurt them, especially when they face the Brooklyn Nets, as he did a pretty good job on Kevin Durant last year in the conference semifinals. But I genuinely don't think a lot of people understand how much of an offensive liability PJ Tucker was. I mean, for him to score one bucket in a game is a good thing, and for him to score more than 2 points in a game is a miracle. Yes, I understand the importance of him whenever the Bucks want to go small with Giannis at the five, but I think the lineup of Bobby Portis and Giannis in the front court is better than the lineup of Giannis and PJ Tucker, because though PJ is better on the defensive end than Bobby is, Bobby is far better offensively than PJ is. I'm telling you, PJ was a fake shooter that was there to foul the opposing team's best wing. That's it. But as far as the rest of the roster, we know what we're going to get from them on the defensive side of the ball. Jrue Holiday, elite defender, one of the best guard defenders of all time. Chris Middleton, a really solid wing defender. You have other capable defenders off the bench in the rotation as well. Brook Lopez is a great rim protector, even made an all defensive team not too long ago for it. Then you have the man that's anchoring the whole thing down in Giannis Antetokounmpo, who's one of the greatest defenders of his generation, and you can make the argument that he is the greatest defender of his generation. And a huge huge testament to their defense is just what they did last season to win a championship. Their shooting wasn't that great, but to compensate, it was their defense and size that was able to make up for it. And when you want to look at the offensive side of the ball, the Bucks have one of the best offenses in the league. They can run the pick and roll, the pick and pop. They have playmakers for that in Jrue Holiday and Chris Middleton. And as far as pushing the ball in the break, we all know they have Giannis Antetokounmpo, who's enough to have one of the best transition offenses in basketball. So as far as their play on the court on both sides of the ball, I don't doubt their effectiveness to be an elite two-way team. And we have seen that when Middleton and Jrue Holiday are hitting their shots in the postseason, they can go toe-to-toe with any team in the NBA. But despite me loving this roster from top to bottom, I have to say the real reason why I think they can win a championship is just look at the competition right now. Not saying that there aren't great teams out there, but a lot of the teams that are contenders are really going through it as we speak. You have the whole Brooklyn Nets situation with Kyrie Irving's vaccination status, combined with the fact that James Harden is obviously a fraud who can't score without foul baiting. Then you look out in Philadelphia and they don't know what the fuck they're gonna do with this Ben Simmons situation. And without Ben Simmons currently, they're not looking too great, I have to say. And outside the Nets and the Sixers, I mean, who else is left in the East that can really challenge the Bucks? The only other team I can think of that maybe stands a chance is the Atlanta Hawks, but let's be honest, they're about a year or two away from legitimate championship contention. And then when you look out west, the Clippers are going through the whole Kawhi Leonard injury thing, so I think they're removed out of the equation for a year. The Nuggets still don't have Jamal Murray back, and even when he gets back, there's going to be, you know, a transition phase, as he's going to be a little bit rusty, I assume. And even if you assume all things go right for the Golden State Warriors and they make it out of the Western Conference, they do not have the size to match up with a guy like Giannis. And yes, I understand the impact of Draymond Green defensively, but at a certain point, come on now, he can't do it all for you. And then that brings us to teams like the Jazz and the Suns, and let's be honest, I don't think those teams are gonna beat the Bucks simply because of the fact that I don't think those teams are as good as the Milwaukee Bucks. Hell, I mean, the Jazz get exposed every year, even though it's really not Gobert's fault. They just lack a lot of wing defense. And then as far as the Suns go, the Bucks just beat them last year. And then that brings us to the final contender out west, and it has to be the Los Angeles Lakers. And please don't even make me laugh, this team isn't going anywhere with Russell Westbrook on their roster. So as far as the field goes, I'm going to bet on the Milwaukee Bucks over the field, because the Bucks have continuity and chemistry, they have championship experience, and they have the most well-balanced roster in the NBA, because they're the one team in the NBA that you could say is great at all aspects of the game. Because sure, you can find teams that have better playmakers than LeBron James and Russell Westbrook, you can find teams that have better scorers than Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving, but you can't find teams that are great at all the aspects of the game collectively. And I think come postseason time, it's going to favor well-balanced teams more than teams that are just elite at one aspect of the game and are lacking at other aspects. So if you ask me right here if I have to put my money on it, give me Bucks and six. Yeah. Bucks and fucking six. But before I wrap up this video, go and check out the latest episode of Hoop Concessions featuring Mojo99. I've been seeing a lot of people ask for a collab between us two, so here you guys go, our first ever guest in the face cam era of Hoop Concessions, and it is Mojo99. It was a great episode and great listen, so make sure you guys go check it out. The link is in the description box down below. But that concludes this video. You guys make sure you drop a like and subscribe to the channel, press that bell for post notifications, and also do not forget to follow me on social media. The links are also in the description box down below. It's your boy Young Mustard signing out. Y'all stay safe and have a blessed day. Peace.